down and two. New England's at their own 33. Brady's in the gun. Four-man rush. Brady moves up. He's hit. The ball chart three.
Uh-oh. Brady gets hit. The ball is out.
It's picked up by Philadelphia. Picked up on the play by Barnett. It was loose, and Brady was trying to throw. He was hit. The ball chart three.
And it's New England's only turnover of the game. Almost gets sacked. Incomplete. Pocket collapsed. They're down to their last play. This is it for New England. Fourth and 10 from the 9. Brady fires, and that'll keep it going. Amendola up at the 20-yard line, but the clock keeps on ticking. Brady. Now he's going to throw short. Gronkowski needs to get out of bounds and does.
There he is.
Boy, oh boy, that took 7 seconds off. Now you got 13. Then you pray for, if not a completion, at least maybe you get a defensive pass interference call.
There is nobody anywhere close to as tall as Rob Gronkowski. I would jam him with the line of scrimmage. I would not let him run freely off this ball.
Brady under pressure.
You cannot win a Super Bowl. You cannot compete for a Super Bowl with a defense that bad.
Launching one for the end zone. There's a jump ball and it's incomplete. And Gronk was there. And time runs out.
If I am a Patriots fan, I am screaming, demanding answers why Malcolm Butler did not play in this game.
Are we witnessing the end of the Brady and Belichick era?
No. We saw that last year in the Super Bowl. That was the end of the era.
The Globe reporting Tom Brady's trainer, Alex Guerrero, has had various team privileges stripped.
Basically, he's not on the charter anymore, not on the sideline anymore.
There have been rumors of friction between Guerrero and the team for a couple of years. So why is this happening now?
It's become clear that tensions between Tom Brady and Bill Belichick are threatening to fracture the Patriots'
Welcome
dynasty.
To Foxborough's Gillette Stadium on opening day 2018.
There's a sense in Foxborough that this year or next will be the last run for Brady and Belichick.
The last couple years, a lot of parts about football weren't enjoyable when they should have been. And I think people are just, they're looking for something to write and talk about. They want to talk about a lot of drama. I'm learning to deal with it better. I just don't give that much anymore about anything, you know. Like, I think a lot of keeping things in perspective, like, nothing's that big a deal to me anymore. To worry about a lot of bull that people can say or think or feel, I really don't care.
Three receivers, and the ball is on the ground! And just like a year ago, the Chiefs in the opener here turned it over on their first snap against the Patriots, and now the Texans do it to open up 2018.
That's the number one goal, is to win championship. Tom Brady, why else would he be playing?
Fires it, and Gronkowski has it. Was he across the pylon? Yes, he was. Touchdown, New England. Touchdown, Patriots!
Can you create some clarity here? Was Gronk on the trading block?
He felt like he's for a disengage from the program and is asking for a raise.
Wide open is White. White makes the cut. He's in for the
There's
touchdown.
More teams in the AFC that can beat New England. New England does. They got a lot of problems. Their offensive line, their defensive
Next
line.
RPO, pass option. Well, here's second and three. And going for the deep ball. Back to the end zone. And it is New England with the football. And the interception by Gilmore, who picked off Watson last year in the matchup. Then carries it for 8, then for 11. And now Brady, all kinds of time down the field. And does he have it? Gronkowski looked to have it. To this quarter.
Way to go, baby!
So Rob Gronkowski being banged up, Tom Brady being 72 years old, Bill Belichick wants to kick it on the
yacht. No, where are you going?
Is the dynasty over? And I know we do this every year, but it seems a little bit different.
Second goal denied. Brady. Touchdown, what a catch! Dorsett!
Brady on third down and 4 looks into the Miami nickel. Hit as he throws, he's got him! White!
this team, there's one guy you don't bet against, and it's even at age 41, the old-ass man, you better not bet against him.
He's able to make the tackle. Brady now over 300 yards for the game, 83rd time in his career, looking for all of it. Unloads to the end zone, caught by Gordon. Touchdown, Patriots. Number 500 in the regular season career of Tom Brady.
Based on what I saw last night, I don't think the Chiefs are losing more than two games this year.
Welcome to Foxborough's Gillette Stadium for this Week 6 encounter with the Pats at 3-2 and the Chiefs for the second straight year racing out to a 5-0 start. Gallman now comes inside. It's a three-man rush. Brady has time. Brady goes deep down the right sideline for Hogan.
But when we're talking about the New England Patriots, we're not even talking about those five losses. Why? Because they win the games that they're supposed to win.
Yep.
They beat the teams that they have to beat to get to where they
are.
Third
and goal. Brady under pressure. A flag is down in the end zone. And Tom gets into the end zone, pending the call.
That means that the road to the Super Bowl is coming through Arrowhead. I only see one team being able to go into Kansas City and beat them.
Steps up, going deep, that field wide open again is Hill. Inside the 30, Hill down the sideline, Hill all the way. Touchdown, Kansas City.
Go win the game.
So I'm here to tell you today that I believe that Kansas City is going to represent the AFC in Super Bowl 50.
Yes, it's not only what their recent history is, but the way they developed these teams. Man, going to Gillette has been lethal. It's been kryptonite, basically, to the rest of the NFL.
First down, 50 seconds. Brady. Deep down the sideline. He goes for Gronkowski. He has it. Josh Short takes him down, but the ball is inside the 10-yard line. For the win. Tied at 40.
What Brady's doing this year, his numbers are remarkable when you consider what he has to work with.
Chicago territory, trailing by three. Brady, pump. Brady is going to run for it. Very close, but not enough. Motion man Edelman. Brady on fourth down, lays it up there. It's caught. Josh Gordon goes upstairs and loses his helmet.
A rookie running back that's been hurt. Another running back who's more of a receiver. They've turned Cordarrelle Patterson, a receiver, into a running back. Gronk's on his last year. Edelman can't catch big balls.
New England regains the lead.
Dorsett's a bust. Gordon couldn't stay in the lead.
It's locked. Ball trying to get scooped up by New England, and they do. Going in for the touchdown, Van Noy. Patriots go in front.
Patriots. They won 13 games last season. A lot of ups, a lot of downs, a lot of drama, a lot of what have yous, but the same old Tom Brady. More or less are the same wins.
Less. No Cooks, no Amendola, no left tackle Nate Solder.
193. Wide open. Well, there are two guys who are there, but it's Josh Gordon, the second guy, into the touchdown.
Throw on that too.
Hold the guy. Alright.
Oh, start the buses!
White will flank him, shifting from the outside. Third and long for New England. Deep drop, Brady deep ball, looking for Gronkowski. He's got it! Touchdown, Patriots! Gronk is back.
Single season, we had the same conversation with the Patriots.
Yep.
It's what did they lose?
Perfect day, man. Couldn't ask for better than this.
Good.
Let's go put it on their ass.
Yep. We're down at three. Blitz coming from Alexander, and Brady is out. Brady's got the first down, and Brady is up to 1,000 rush yards. 24 yards. 15 yards, 12 yards. Brady throws another big one. Gordon for the touchdown.
How many playoff games did they win? One, two, or three? That's the only variety. That's it. Last year was two. The question is whether or not they win the Super Bowl.
And picked off by Daron Harmon.
People are talking about the Patriots. Their dynasty is done. Tom Brady, it's over for him. Rob Gronkowski, he's too slow. He can't do it anymore. Bill Belichick is not the same coach he once was. So on and so forth.
Brady steps up. Brady puts one. End zone. Caught by Gronkowski. Touchdown, New England.
This team just isn't talented enough. The New England Patriots are in a stretch right now with this 2018 team that is probably the worst one since 2013.
Seven seconds left. Tannehill will throw it, and this will end it after the shovel, or will it? Miami running around, circling, oh look out! Gronkowski didn't have the angle! Touchdown! Oh, Kenyon Drake! A miracle! The Patriots fall to 9-4, a damaging loss for New England.
The Patriots, he called it Redemption Sunday. You watch, he said, it's going to be Redemption Sunday. They still got to hold off Brady and company.
If I'm Brady, I'm doing a double move on the outside, and I'm taking a shot right here. It might be your last chance. You get one-on-one.
Mr. Cool takes the snap from the pocket with all kinds of time. Goes to the end zone, and it's over the head of everyone.
But this New England team is old, beat up, with second-tier weapons for the greatest quarterback that's ever played.
You got Rock on the bottom.
Third and 15, 26 seconds. Give him time, and again goes in the direction of Gronkowski. It's fourth down. Well, last week, New England fell victim to the miracle in Miami. Now, can they come up with a miraculous touchdown of their own?
Man, in the last two, three plays, there's been nothing available on the outside. They've gone down the field. He thinks he's going to have something. He's running the same exact look on offense to get what he wants. We'll see.
Steelers drop back right around the first down yardage at the six. Here's Brady down the middle.
All things come to an end. They really do. I mean, Tom Brady, he's over.
And it's knocked down, incomplete. Intended for Edelman. And after three difficult and demoralizing weeks.
You know what the best thing that could happen to Joy and us this weekend? The Patriots get blown out. And the dynasty dies. Because a lot of people are connecting me to New England through the years. I see the numbers. They'll tune in to see what I have to say about the dynasty that got crushed. They roll them. They beat him 47-10. It is awful. Brady stinks. That is great for my business. But that's not going to happen because New England's going to win.
Well, Tom Brady, for the 13th time in an AFC title game, 2-3 in AFC Championship games on the road. In fact, losing the last three that he played on the road, all of them to Peyton Manning.
So far in this game, they've got to go back to the Brady sneak or something, don't they? Oh, they're killing it. Usually means a motion and a run out wide to the right.
Here's the handoff and to the end zone! It's Sony Michel and the Patriots are back in front.
Stay focused! They don't score no more points, we win!
Jones was hurt on the fall, so he's come out for this play. Second and 10. Watkins, 20, 10. Switch back down to the 2. Play on the north side of it. Handoff up the middle.
practice hard in the fourth quarter against the Legion of Boom in the Super Bowl, or down 28-3 to Atlanta, throwing for 246 just in the fourth quarter in overtime to bring them all the way back. It's just hard.
Third straight year, or will the Chiefs go back for the first time in 49 years? Minute and 57 to decide it. Brady fires complete. Edelman, what a catch.
Tom Brady is the most feared player in the National Football League.
To Edelman. You just look up there and kick him.
New England does have less talent, but this has become their brand.
Goes down the field to Gronk, turns around, makes the catch.
But outside of Brady, talent doesn't win games.
There's a handoff to Burkhead. Burkhead pulls ahead and scores the touchdown.
We do not root for teams. We root for stories.
Touchdown, Patriots! And they regain the lead with 39 seconds on the clock in this AFC Championship.
Stepping up.
Pass near side.
To Ware. Clock running. Now you get up, you clock it right away or time.
New England again, you're the visiting team. It's your choice.
Heads.
Heads.
Heads is the call.
It is heads.
You want the ball.
Matthew Slater makes that very clear. We want the ball.
There have been other great quarterbacks. There have been other great quarterbacks to have great moments. But I don't believe there's been a quarterback that can call upon his greatness time after time when they needed the
game
most.
Is over. This is a whole new game right now. The adjustments have taken place. You've seen what the opponent has done successfully throughout the game. Now, right here, I'd do the same thing. I'd be aggressive right from the way.
And when they needed it the most, when he needs to be absolutely great, he can do it.
Ending it right down the field they go.
They're putting the big guys in. They're trying to stop the run on the first play.
Shoved out by Fuller. Hogan with the grab.
Nobody's getting open. Brady's literally trying to go through four guys, and over again, it's really hard to find someone creating a lot of separation. It's why I keep saying Gronk's got to get out wide, and you got to throw it to him out there.
Third and nine, Tony.
Well, they got to block the front. Gronk's not outside. You got to chip with him, and throw to Edelman over the middle of the field.
Down the middle. Caught. Edelman holds on.
He got whacked a couple of times.
Second and 10. Pass. Drop. Patterson couldn't catch it.
Yeah, Tom Brady looked at Pat Mahomes and said, "You're going to have to cry this for my cold, dead fingers," right? And that's exactly what happened.
Here we go.
To deny this level of greatness at this point in time, it reflects on you, not him.
Running back's got to help you. He has time to throw. Once again, Edelman in the middle of the field.
Pocket sealed. Down the middle. Edelman again with a third down catch. Third and 10. Ball at the Chiefs 30.
Gronk is out wide. Watch the top of your screen. Watch this safety. If he comes down, there's a good chance he's throwing out there.
It's Gronk for the first down.
So much for Gronk being washed up and done. And I think Gronk, just like Tom Brady all year long, battling injuries.
There's such a Greek theater element to this game. And we'll go back and watch this a million times in the history of NFL films. This game will be revisited because you have the young gun, Patrick Mahomes, 23 years old, and then you have the old guard, Tom Brady, 41 years old, and this torch that Brady just refused to let go of.
England tried to play action earlier. I can't see it here. This has to be a run.
Second and goal to Burkhead. Burkhead to the end zone. Hello, Super Bowl. New England is heading back again for the third straight year.
But this might be one of his crowning achievements. He'll let night think of admire this piece that he painted yesterday. Because to go on the road and beat this high power of an offense is unbelievable. And he needed every ounce of his greatness. And he came through with flying color.
Way to go, baby. Way to go. What a game. Love you, Tim. What a game. Do we have that any other way?
Nope. On the road.
The reason NFL players are rooting for the Steelers to win the AFC, are rooting for the Chargers to win the AFC, are rooting for the Kansas City Chiefs.
Congratulations. Third year in a row, 5 out of 6. The Patriots going back to the Super Bowl.
In regards, what the Patriots do is what is also not so slowly happening to society. It's called automation.
The AFC Champions, New England Patriots.
Years ago, I was talking to an NFL player, and he goes, "Guy, your players hate New England." And I'm like, well, players, you know, players just hate who's winning. And the player said to me, no. We don't hate everybody that's winning. We hate New England.
Tom Brady was a clutch game-managing quarterback at the beginning of his career with a great defense. And then he became the GOAT, and he could carry your offense, and you didn't need to devote as many resources to the defense. And now Belichick has recognized, I got to start doing that again. And lo and behold, the Patriots tried out an elite defense.
All day today, fellas, have each other's back. One last time for the 2018 season. We've been through everything to be here in this moment. Tonight is the night. Show the world.
I need every help. I need all that anger, that pain, everything they got to feel it today.
But to say he's not a game manager now, even last year his stats had fallen way off. Not just from the previous season, but from many seasons.
Love you, bro. All right, let's get ready to go now. Let's get ready to go.
5 Super Bowl wins, 0 chance he says that he would retire after this game, regardless of the outcome.
They doubted him all year. He loves it when he gets to play the underdog role. It's been a long time. He wants this one bad. We talked about it in the opening. He wants this one as bad as he's wanted anyone. That's what he told us.
And this New England offense, third time already residing on the Rams side of the field.
Third down and 5. Brady takes, moves up, he's under pressure.
All game long, each team clawed for a scoring drive, but were stopped time and time again.
That hot hand was Anderson, here's 3rd and 2. And they move the chains all kinds of times with Goff. Trout flushed out.
Concern over the face of Bill Belichick because Patrick Chung was injured. Chung injured on the tackle. Chung, who was injured last year, came against Philadelphia and was concussed and was not available at the end of that one.
Well, that's a big loss. I really feel like Chung is one of those players that does so much for this defense. They use a few guys in a lot of different ways.
Talking about Patriots defense that only had 30 sacks, which is second fewest, and they got 4 sacks.
You go back away from it.
They
there
also
you go.
Play quicker here to the line. Goff throws, completes it to Cook.
And I don't know how many pressures on Jerry Goff.
And make a big throw to Goff.
Coming after him. Stands in there and completes it to Woods.
You look at that defensive game plan by the New England Patriots to be able to hold the second highest scoring team in the National Football League to 3 points. My God, I mean, what a game.
Stand up right here and stop this play action.
There it is. Goff steps up, he's going for the big ball to the end zone.
Oh, it's not.
There wasn't a Patriot within 10 yards. Jason McCourty closed quickly. That should have been six.
It is an unbelievable play by Jason McCourty. He comes from the opposite side of the field.
Instead of the game's first touchdown, it was the best defensive play in the lowest scoring Super Bowl ever.
No negative plays here from the 26 of New England. You're in tying field goal range.
To the 19 for a first. Coming after him. Oh, they take him way back. Now forcing a long field goal attempt. Had it been an incompletion, it would have been 44 yards. Only four all time in the Super Bowl. Field goals made from plus 50. This is 53 yards to tie it. And Zuerlein's kick is good.
At some point in the game, you have to just be willing to say, like, we're not going to score 32.
Put together a good drive.
You know, we need a drive. A drive. And that might be enough.
This is the key right here, all right? Good fundamental football. Let's go.
We kind of decide as a group, forget about the game plan for a second.
Of the offense, right?
That's the future of the game, right?
Yeah.
Brady on first down, lofts it. Gronkowski has it.
All of a sudden, breakthrough. All of a sudden, you could just feel the momentum.
Brady chance starting here.
A double move here. Gronk up the seam. Running back down the sideline.
Let's see, what can we come up with based on what has happened in the game?
I got to credit Josh McDaniels with this because he's calling the play. They come out with Rex Burkhead three straight times, split out receiver.
Again with Rex Burkhead out to the left side. Brady looking that way at the snap. He throws to Burkhead to catch at the 34 and goes out of bounds left sideline.
Good play, Rex. Good play.
Everyone's got a win.
This is the Tom Brady I know right now. Number 12 is in a rhythm. They're spreading him out. He's taking what the defense is giving him. Patience, patience. I'm telling you, he's going to cut one loose right down the seam here.
All of a sudden, with the money on the table, with the stakes the highest, with the Super Bowl teetering at 3-3.
Same exact play again. Edelman over the middle.
Second and three.
Brady to Gronk. A sixth ring.
Down the field, they go! Gronkowski has it at the 2-yard line!
Now the Patriots will run their first play in the red zone. The first one for the game on the either side from the two. First and goal.
Running it! And a touchdown! Sony Michel.
But it's fourth quarter and it's money time for the greatest guy to ever suit it up. You give him the ball when the game's on the line.
Some things never change.
Guys, keep falling. We'll be all right. Hey, we're going to get something now.
Brady threw the strike of the game. He threw the best throw of the game for the biggest gain of the whole night.
Coach Belichick pulled out a virtuoso. This was probably his greatest coaching performance.
With 4.5 to play. Pass, caught, no! In and out of the hands of Cooks.
They averaged 33 points a game. So he held them to 30 points less than what they normally get per game.
Well, you know, they're taking shots down the field now.
Blitz to the end zone.
Gronkowski, you don't know, might be his final game. When you're good, it always finds a way when it matters.
Woo!
Brady now has six rings thanks to six game-winning drives in the fourth quarter or overtime. That is impossibly all-time clutch.
How sweet is this one of all the ones you've had?
It's sweet. It's sweet, Jim. Everybody counted us out from the beginning of the season to mid-season.
Shane wrote us off all year.
They were dead or left for it earlier this season. In New England, it's personal.
Years from now, we're going to be somewhere sitting back, feet kicked up. And somebody going to ask, tell me about the 18 team. Don't forget what it felt like when they said you weren't good enough. You shouldn't be here. You can't play. You're old. Exactly.
Truly an unprecedented accomplishment, but there is one constant throughout this whole 18 years. Two men who are the best at what ever has been done in the history of the NFL. Bill Belichick and Tom Brady.
Tom Brady not only broke the record books, broke all of our brains about what greatness in the NFL is supposed to look like. From 2014 to 2020, every other year he won the Super Bowl.
That's pretty good.
Prior to Tom Brady, the high watermark, impossible standard was four rings. Two rings was, are you the best quarterback ever? Like that was this, like John Elway was in the argument as the best quarterback ever because he got to two.
Wild, of course. 0-1, 0-3, 0-4, 14, 16, and 18. And here come the 2019 edition of the New England Patriots.
Special, and this crowd is a buzz.
Quarterback in high school and at Kent State. And then Brady shoots one to Josh Gordon. Gordon breaking tackles, touchdown, New England.
Steve Young got one ring. Brett Favre got one ring. Kurt Warner got one ring. And nobody was like, ah, disappointing. You know what I mean? Didn't.
Right.
But Brady broke our brains on
it. Yardage. The 25 again off play action. And open for the touchdown. Dorsett.
He absolutely loved everything about the game of football. He loved watching film. He loved meeting. He loved, obviously, you love the game. You love to hear the roar of the crowd.
What a snap. And wide, wide open. Philip Dorsett. Big night for him. Touchdown. 58 yards.
I can't say. You know what? Hey, forget the rings. Mahomes better than him. Because it is such a body of work, and it's so overwhelming. We also saw the games.
Forming their identity and developing it over the course of a season.
Brady, end zone, caught by Brown. Touchdown, New England. Antonio Brown, the newest Patriot.
New England climbed to an undefeated 8-0 record, once again looking like Super Bowl favorites.
And again, the block at the right tackle. Oh, Brady looking to the side! Caught by Gordon! Right in front of Roberts!
Patriots now out to the 3-0 start.
3-0 is a good feeling, but you don't really get anything for three wins. We got to do a lot more
than this. To play in the third. Brady to throw. Under pressure, throws it, has a man open, he's got it, to the end zone, touchdown, Brandon Bolden. One plays to the Giants, 42, here's one for Edelman, leaping grab and down inside the five. Now to the end of this first quarter, second and eight, Brady's going to take a shot, and Philip Dorsett with the touchdown catch. Pressure off the edge. Ball is out. And the Patriots have it. Kyle Van Noy on the return. Inside the five and walks it in. Outrageous, this defense.
defense.
He is Tom Brady. Every record, passing record that you could possibly have, every playoff, whatever measure you want to use for a player in a team sport, he has it.
Floated again and picked off again. This time it's Terrence Brooks.
Same goes.
Question can come across a little crazy, and I want to define it. We're asking, is the dynasty over in New England? But let me define dynasty. I'm talking about a team that is winning the division year in and year out and is in the playoff picture. Is that over for New England?
Absolutely. The dynasty is over.
This is Chris Collinsworth. Michelle DeFoya, Patriots are off to a perfect start. They're 8-0. They have steamrolled the opposition. Tonight, their toughest test yet. The opposite team with a quarterback who can run. And here goes Brown again. And Brown with a big game down the sideline all the way to the 25-yard line. He keeps it. To the end zone, touchdown.
Warriors had a dynasty for 5 years. Alabama's had it for 10 years. And the Patriots have had it for 20 years. And they're all ended. They're all ended.
This place is playoff caliber electric tonight. It's third down and 7. As Brady retreats and gets sacked back to the 28-yard line. Hand the ball off to Ingram. Mark Ingram, big run into Patriot territory. Can they chase him down? Not until he gets to the 12-yard line.
You're never going to see this again. This has been the perfect storm.
The Ravens are tonight.
Well, most football fans are at this point. Edwards to the end zone. Touchdown.
The Ravens lead at 17-0. And the Patriots find themselves in their largest deficit this season. This is unbelievable. The Patriots with 3 possessions, 2 3-and-outs. Bailey's punt is fumbled.
Catch is called for and fumbled by Jones. And the Patriots come up with it. Edelman is the man in motion. Brady looking that way. Brady to the outside. That'll be caught for a touchdown by Mohamed Sanu. And the Patriots, who were down 17-0.
20 years, 9 Super Bowls, and 6 wins. This is never going to happen again in football.
Edelman again. And the ball is out. And there's no whistle yet. And this is Marlon Humphrey who's going to take it to the end zone. It'll be 70 yards if it stands. So Edelman submarined the first guy. Brown in full throat. Blitz coming, but it's picked up, and Brady's going for 6. Deep downfield. And then we picked off at the 7-yard line by Earl Thomas. And Thomas with a run back all the way out to the 33-yard line.
Patriots lost for the first time this year. 37-20 to the Baltimore Ravens.
Baltimore exposed New England, and they stumbled to a 4-5 finish, with many media outlets proclaiming the end of their dynasty.
Anything settled with this passing game from the beginning of the year, and I talked about it before, those inside routes are key.
3rd and 4, meanwhile this is going to be picked off. Bradley Roby's going to set up a 1st and goal for the Texans.
Bill Belichick has said it himself. They sold out.
35%. 36, and he's going to get sacked. And that's Roby firing through.
I bet they fall back.
Blake Lockman all the way down. Watson directing traffic. Going to try it again, and that time it will be caught. Kenny Stills for the touchdown. From the 20-yard line now, Brady. And he throws, and that's Edelman who makes the catch. With a touchdown. Really? For 50 seconds.
They sold out over the last 5 years to try to win as many Super Bowls as they did. And they got a couple.
1 out of 7 are recovered by the kicking team. Bailey puts it in play. Look at this. And it goes out of bounds. Brandon Bolden almost had it. Almost had it. He got a flag down as well.
But against a good team on the road, and when you don't play good, you don't win. So we didn't deserve it.
The showdown between the Chiefs and Patriots had serious playoff implications. Unfortunately, the game didn't come down to a great play by Tom Brady or Patrick Mahomes. Instead, the outcome was shaped by several dubious calls by the officials.
Touchdown, New England!
Hold on here.
The officials now are going to say he was out at the three, but he did not step out of bounds.
But the dynasty is over. The next 3 or 4 years are going to look very, very different.
The problem is they have no challenges. They can't do anything about it.
Again, if there's indecision, if you're not sure, call the touchdown so then he can have a look at the replay review.
How frustrating is that?
That's two calls against New England that are points.
Really?
Each one.
Does it feel like the beginning of the end for the Patriots guys?
It really does.
The game moves too fast for these referees. And even with help, they can't get it right.
Brady. Wide open out here is Roberts, the linebacker, to the 10, to the 5, touchdown. How about that? This one's going to go deep, and the catch is made by Devontae Parker. Inside the 30 at the 29. Fitzpatrick throwing over the middle, touchdown. Mike Gesicki. Well, the stadium got real quiet real quick, and look at these Miami Dolphins celebrate.
Nobody, and when you say nobody, I mean nobody, a meaningful game at the end of the year to get into a position to get a bye in the 1-2 seed, this is a New England team. It's different. You can feel it. This could be the end. We don't know for sure. Tonight, everyone expects them to win. I don't think it's going to end like this, but it could, and you could be watching it tonight.
You came at the line, you got to get it blocked, and then you got to make a tight throw quickly.
They look like the Patriots. No, they haven't looked like the Patriots all year.
Tannehill, end zone, touchdown, Tennessee. Berkser was open, and the backup tight end hauls it in for the score. What a drive to open things for the Titans.
Lead us 12.
Brady's yelling at Julian, get in your spot.
Julian was not targeted in that first half. Got the handoff, and he can strut in for the touchdown untouched.
We've seen the Patriots struggle at different points in time during the season, but not a prolonged struggle on the offensive side of the football.
Got back to Henry. Big game.
He's just way bigger than you. How do you get him down?
Man, he's fast.
He's too good. He's too good. 23-yard line. Play action coming over to Henry. Henry takes the screen pass, and he's pushed out, I think, inside the one.
The Titans have the type of team that can cause the Patriots problem.
Touchdown, Tennessee.
You called it. Henry get all the work, and he got it again.
But I'm about to pick Ryan Tannehill over Tom Brady in a playoff game in Foxborough, Massachusetts, and I never thought I would see the day.
Quarterback's getting knocked on his tail.
Most in the league, and Kern gets a line drive punt away that's bounding to a halt at the one. Perfection.
You could be the one to dethrone the dynasty. To end it,
the two of them together.
It is.
Yes, I mean, it's. We'll never see this run again, Jim.
Brady's pass is intercepted and returned for a touchdown by Logan Ryan, the former Patriot.
The Green Dynasty, obviously, what was
I'm
on the
tell
line.
Everyone right now that I believe, I think he's coming back to play. What I saw out of him, not only today, but when I watched him this year, he is not done. He needs help around him.
Bill Belichick has strapped Tom Brady with his worst supporting cast by far.
Just want to see the reaction here as Brady walks off the field. Will he ever step foot on Gillette turf again?
Bill, do you anticipate the Patriots will bring back Tom Brady for the 2020 season?
Right now, we just finished the game, so we're focused on this game, okay?
Tom Brady has announced he is leaving the New England Patriots.
And there it is. All of a sudden, you go from not knowing to he's gone. And so, look, I don't want to get sappy over it. There's a measure of sadness in a story like this because of what the guy has meant to the region. But if you're asking me why it happened, the Patriots wouldn't commit to Tom Brady beyond 1 year
And he said, well, then I want to go to market and find a multi-year deal. And he
has. Tom Brady to the Bucks. Your thoughts?
Well, I got no problems with it whatsoever. You know, you've got Evans there, but you've got a receiver. You've got guys like O.J. Howard, guys like that in his tight end spot. You see the personnel they had. It would have been nice if DeSean Jackson was still there, but he left a year ago to come back to Philadelphia. But in the end, when you look at their stud receivers, you look at the brilliant offensive mind of a Bruce Arians, and you look at the fact that they were starving for some level of productivity from the quarterback position.
Jeff Darlington has been all over this story from the very beginning. Jeff, what can you tell us?
Tom Brady, now officially a member of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
After 20 years as a Patriot, Tom Brady's helmet had a pirate flag on it.
Tom Brady and the Buccaneer offense will set up after a 39-yard punt, and I don't think there's been a more anticipated uniform change maybe in the history of the league to see what the GOAT looks like in pewter.
he looks pretty good, doesn't he? I know he's excited. We talked to him the other day, and it's been a long time. Probably you go back to Randy Moss's years with the New England Patriots since he's had a supporting cast like this.
Brady keeps. Throws. Pass is caught. That's Chris Godwin, who broke out last year, and he's out.
Is it Brady or Belichick? It's one of the hottest debates in sports for like 20 years. And now we want to see it.
Jones spent a lot of time working on his receiving skills in the last several months.
Three tight ends in the lineup. Here's one downfield, and Evans cannot make the catch, but a flag is thrown.
So this is not just a good receiving group. This is now the top tight end and receiving group.
In the ball game, Brady's going to keep and take it in for the touchdown. Slams it down, and he's got a touchdown for the exclamation point at the end of his first drive as quarterback of the Tampa Bay Bucks. Reeves has been looking for Cook on third down so far. Here it's Kamara for the touchdown. Alvin Kamara with a catch and run and a touchdown of 12 yards.
Just some pretty basic mistakes in this game by Tampa.
On second and 15, this one's picked. Back the other way for the touchdown. It's Janoris Jenkins, a pick six.
Bruce Arians, by the way, calls him out, which I think is good for the team, saying those two interceptions were on Brady.
Tom Brady, it's not as if he's doing anything that is fantastic. So, no, the Bucs do not yet look like Super Bowl contenders.
But everyone was talking about Tom Brady's about to win the MVP. He's still elite, da-da-da. No, he's not, and no, he's not. It is what it is. This is what a 43-year-old quarterback on a new team looks like.
Bradley's defensive unit has been the best in the red zone for the first 3 weeks of the season. This is a third and goal. Brady tosses. Touchdown! Mike Evans grabs it for the score. What a turn here in Tampa.
Volunteer mention.
If that's your mention for the day, we'll move on.
Is that it? Is that all?
Brady, home run ball on the way, and it's hauled in. Scotty Miller over the shoulder for the Buccaneers. For 46 yards downfield. Fake it. Oh, he can't do it any better. Brady to Miller. Touchdown, Tampa Bay.
Second down is long. Take the running play. Brady timing round.
50-50 ball, it belongs to Gronk.
After orchestrating a 17-point comeback in Week 4, Brady redefined Tampa's culture and proceeded to clinch a playoff berth, ending a 12-year playoff drought.
Territory for Tampa Bay. Brady all day, downfield. Touchdown, Scotty Miller.
And here's the thing. If they protect him, which they have, he's the best quarterback in football.
First down and goal. Ends up being a 9-yard penalty. Brady throwing for Evans in his neighborhood. Got it. Touchdown. Tampa the lead. And Brady retakes the touchdown pass lead over Drew Brees as well.
Four-man rush. Brady airing it out. Going deep. He's got it to Antonio Brown. Touchdown, Tampa Bay.
He threw for 50 touchdowns this year.
at age 43.
7 games in, Tom Brady has transformed the Buccaneers franchise.
He's going to go down as the most celebrated quarterback in the history of the National Football League.
Without Bill Belichick there to give him the team's success that masks his decline, he's obviously in decline.
By the way, the targets are also big. Mike Evans is 6'6". Gronk is 6'6". He's got big.
A little bit touched in the center there.
Red zone chance. Looking for Gronk. And he's got it for a touchdown. Back-to-back weeks.
Big targets in the red zone.
And there's not a lot of feeling that there's, like, ego.
But the first time he has a game where he doesn't throw 3 tugs, it's going to be like, oh, well, here it is. You know, here's the beginning. And then, sure enough, there's a little more ammo for him to be like, what'd you say?
To the end zone for Miller, and it is caught for a touchdown.
Welcome inside the Mercedes-Benz Superdome for today's divisional round matchup. The New Orleans Saints and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, number 1 and number 2 all-time in passing yardage and passing touchdowns, square off here in the playoffs for the first time.
When we're talking about the playoffs, that's a different level of understanding. That's a different level of expertise.
Second and 9 now. This one's picked. Intercepted by the Bucs. It's Murphy bunting down the sideline. He is going to be marked out at the 3.
And nobody in the history of football understands that better than Tom Brady.
Brady throws, pass, caught, Evans, touchdown.
He's done it with a lot of different players over the years. That's what I marvel at the most. I think when you look at quarterbacks like myself who have won multiple Super Bowls, it's usually with the same group of guys.
Well, now they've got Winston lined up wide to the outside in a direct snap to Kamara. Now Winston, now Tre'Quan Smith. Flag is down. Smith is into the end zone for a touchdown.
Jameis Winston with a touchdown pass against his former team to take the lead.
What a find by Mickey Loomis and Jeff Ireland in the 3rd round. Saints have run it 6 straight times. Now Montgomery makes the catch. End zone, Smith spinning, and they got it for the touchdown.
Touchdown, Tre'Quan Smith. Yes, sir.
I fear that guy in that moment, in that stadium.
Nobody's celebrating. Ain't nobody doing nothing. We got to bring that juice.
I still fear Brady in a game like that.
Brady with play action. He finds Brady. Cameron Brate.
See if Tom Brady could work his magic now. Need a touchdown and a point to tie.
Good protection again. Pass caught. Touchdown Fournette.
Touchdown Tampa Bay. It's Leonard Fournette. And we're tied at 20-0.
Tom Brady is going to break every playoff record. Michael Jordan doesn't own every playoff record.
I'm going to put the dagger in. Wow.
No catches for Michael Thomas. You see the total yards in the game. 2nd and 8. Brees throws and he's picked by Devin White. Another turnover and White picks his way down the sideline. 2nd and 8. Brady throws. He's got Gronk. And Gronk is set up 1st and goal. Brady's going to take it. Touchdown. That's going to do it.
Tell you what, that is going to be one heck of a plane ride back to Tampa Bay for this football team. Mm-hmm.
Hey, brother.
How you playing, bro?
You too, man. I'm playing. Appreciate
love you, man.
You too.
Yeah,
everything awesome. About you, man.
I'll be in touch.
All right. Yeah,
sounds all right.
Good. Take care.
Best luck,
all right?
Tom Brady! Good job, man. Good job, man. Good job, man. Good job, man.
You do intercept
all come on,
passes.
Man.
These fools let exactly what those of us who have been burnt by Tom Brady for 2 decades.
Gonna make a change for once.
So should he retire, Stephen A? Yes.
I have the rest of the show and this entire week and beyond to pick you apart in that ridiculous, asinine argument that you just made. It is blasphemous. It is hideous. It is very disrespectful what you have said to this man. You owe this man an apology. I want to state this for the record. That man, like that, owed that damn Tom Brady an apology.
Okay. Held the Rams to 2 for 8. Brady floats it. He's got Evans. What a throw and a sliding catch. catch. Evans is going to be marked down inside the 35. Was not enough to eat. Who am I to be blind? Brady throws, ends up. To see their and he's got Evans for the touchdown. Disregard. A broken bottle top. Third down conversions on their way down the field.
What we all saw coming right down the tracks. They've let it all happen.
Good matchup with Corey Linsley, one of the best in the game. Here's one down the sideline. It is caught. Touchdown, Green Bay.
I will be surprised if the Bucks or Brady or whoever figures out a way to win this game. I will be surprised.
Okay.
That's the God's truth from the bottom of my soul.
Brady slides. He's going for Godwin downfield. And a juggle and a catch. If you want to make the world a better place, take a look at yourself. On first down, Fournette stutter steps and now is able to bounce. What a move. A spin and... touchdown! What a run by Leonard Fournette!
No, that's 30 seconds. It's this quarter. Oh. Yeah, they're trying to get, I'm going to say we need to stop. Don't let them get no points.
PP's gotten after him a couple times now. He's really made Turner almost anticipate the snap count. Here's a pick by Murphy Bunting.
Big! Big! That's a big!
It comes to all-time greats, whether you like it or not. They are going to be measured at their quarterback position by how many Super Bowls they win.
Making plays like that against this red-hot Green Bay offense, that's big time. On third down, this one for Brates. It is incomplete and nearly picked.
Go for it!
They're going to go for it.
We talk about Aaron Rodgers all the time as one of the most talented ever, but one of the questions, if not the biggest question tied to him is, why has he only won one?
Fourth down and three. The pass is caught. The first down picked up by Fournette.
Can they run something quick, stop the clock, and give themselves a chance to at least attempt a field goal?
We're going
to
try to get out of bounds here.
Oh, yeah, see. Either end zone or out of bounds. Run, bunch, snap. Everyone's got to go.
Look, there's only one reason why Tampa has any chance in the playoffs at all. You got Tom Brady.
They pick up no more yardage. Brady goes for the deep shot. He's got a touchdown! Scotty Miller!
Oh my God!
Behind the defense and for 39 yards gets the touchdown and what a half, oh, by Tom Brady.
Hey, you already know.
And that's it. Tom Brady is going back to the Super Bowl, this time as a member of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
So Tom Brady, this was pretty remarkable. He needed complete isolation. His family's giving him 12 days off. He has not seen them for six, and they won't be back until another six. Has there ever been anybody this dedicated in your life?
Can I say hi to my son? Love you, kiddo. How about that? Let's go to the Super Bowl, baby. What do you think? I love you, man. Way to go. I'll see you. I'll call you a little bit later. All right. Love you, kiddo.
If we can now bring along a guy who's pretty responsible for this, number 12 right there, 43 years old, 10th trip to the Super Bowl, Tom. When you made the decision to come to Tampa, what was your vision?
Let's go back to the GOAT talk. Did Brady finally put an end to it, even in the future? It's all said and done. Brady's the GOAT. No one's ever going to take that away.
We're on the biggest stage. The world is watching. What you going to do? This all out. We're going to protect this for everything in us.
Greeny, when we were talking before he joined the Bucs, it wasn't like everybody was sitting there saying, oh, the Bucs, that team's loaded. They're going to make a Super Bowl run. We barely had them in the playoffs at that point. Yes, they're a talented team. But nobody's picking them to win the Super Bowl in 2020.
realistically, you don't beat the Chiefs. I don't think anybody can beat the Chiefs. Patrick Mahomes is too effective. And you don't just have to outplay Patrick Mahomes. You have to outcoach Andy Reid.
I think I'm comfortable using the word scoffing. People scoffed at the idea that Tampa might be one of the places he would choose when we started going through that exercise. And lo and behold, here they are, suddenly the team everybody wants to play for.
Back in March when he was a free agent, 30 teams passed on him and thought their quarterback situation was better. Only two teams were interested. That was the Chargers in Tampa Bay.
From the 45, six DBs on the field for the Chiefs.
He went to an organization, guys, that had the worst winning percentage in the history of the NFL.
I'm excited to get a patch for about this game.
Play action. They go to break with Blocker in front.
Jinx Spagnuolo? Usually it's the guy you're talking about.
One of those weird announcer jinxes here.
I hadn't been to the playoffs in a dozen years. And then just won the Super Bowl and kind of did it relatively easily.
Brady's pass, it's Gronkowski! Back again!
You guys are gonna sit here and pretend they're not scared. They're scared.
Nobody in the history of football has been in more pressure moments and shown up big for his team than Tom Brady.
Now it's tough to stop again.
Brady, play action. Third option, end zone. But Gronkowski again with the touchdown.
I'm saying to you that when it comes to Patrick Mahomes against Tom Brady, we're going to remember that they got beat down.
Let's go, Tom. You beat me. You've been here before.
Yes, sir. We got to go.
When you get beat down like that, and it's at the hands of Brady, people are going to remember that.
This will live on the test of time forever against Brady in this situation.
He is taken down by Shaq Barrett.
Riddle me this. All of a sudden, they look dangerous. Brady looks good. Mike Evans is clicking. The defense is forcing turnovers.
Big play here. Coming after him. Way back. All the way to the 35, and it's incomplete. That was Shaq Barrett. Townsend on the hole. And that kick is high and good.
He has nowhere to go. Nowhere to go.
It's all night. Keep your voice. Keep doing your thing. That should have been another one right there.
Yeah, we're going to score a lot more.
Let's go, Tommy.
Say that's a catch.
With 18 seconds, Brady goes in the middle of the field to Fournette, who powers down to the...
You fake it here, and then you run on the next one if you don't get it.
There's the fake, there's the pass, and there's the catch for the touchdown, Antonio Brown!
That's why you don't get scared, baby!
Should Tom Brady retire?
Yes, he should. He won't, but he should. Not only has the cliff come, he can still make throws. Yes, he can, but he misses guys every way you can miss a guy.
He's old, and the other players in his position can do more things who are elite.
Brady threw for three first-half touchdowns, burying the Chiefs alive before the second half even began.
Our best right here!
It's Gronkowski running!
Chiefs were reeling.
Can you imagine what this is going to do for Tom Brady, who had six rings before he walked
right
in the
yesterday's
game? And then to now do this?
My point
is untouchable.
Fournette! Touchdown, Tampa Bay!
He did it yesterday against all odds to me because I didn't see it coming.
Stuff happened.
Hasn't completed a pass on third down tonight.
Can he do it this time? Reverse his course. He's all the way back at the 30. Barrett is on him. Heaves it before the whistle. And Pringle has it in his hands. They rule it incomplete. That was craziness.
Listen, I love Patrick. No one raves about Patrick more than me. The conversation is now over. He will not catch Tom Brady.
To the middle. Fourth and 9. Again, running for his life. Mahomes got it away. Incomplete. White knocks it down. It was intended for Darrell Williams.
One more snap. Would you have guessed when this impossible season was trying to launch that you'd get it all in, you'd get to Tampa, and when the Super Bowl ended, the ball would be in the hands of Tom Brady?
He goes on the road and beats three Hall of Famers, three of the all-time greats.
You're a legend, man. Congrats, man. You're a legend. You're amazing, man.
Yeah, let's keep it tight.
Yeah, for sure.
He goes on the road and beats Drew Brees. He goes on the road and beats Aaron Rodgers. And then it beats Patrick. We agree Patrick will more than likely be a Hall of Famer.
Thank you so much.
That's what we want.
Congrats. That's 7. That's 7. That's 7.
You know, buddy.
This is what we do.
This is what we do.
There are two tighties.
Two tighties.
Saving up for the Super Bowl.
You did it all.
I mean, this is not only did Tom go win his 7th, Tom won his 7th and went on the greatest Super Bowl run a quarterback's ever been on.
How about that?
Here's my boy.
Dad!
You guys happy?
In a season we will never forget, you are the Super Bowl champions. We will always remember. The Vince Lombardi Trophy is staying in Tampa Bay.
It's not close anymore. Brady has lapped Gretzky, and he's lapped Michael Jordan. I want you to think about it.
Why don't you hand that off to number 12? Jason, congratulations. Let us bring in Tom Brady, Super Bowl champion for the 7th time.
Tom's the best quarterback ever. So it's pretty amazing when you start looking at sports arguments, this one's done.
Brady had the most to gain in these entire playoffs, and he did it. He proved everything. He proved everything. This was an enormous legacy game.
Now, all those things come into play this week when you're playing the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Because even with what Tampa's been this entire season, that's still Tom Brady over there. That's still Mike Evans. That's still Chris Godwin. That's still players that can go out and make plays offensively. And the defense that we saw in 2020 with many of the same players.
He's throwing this thing around because he's so much smarter than what he was then.
At the age of 44, Brady steps up, avoids the rush, throws, caught! Touchdown, Antonio Brown. And that kick,
how about that,
is good right in the middle. So at the most opportune time, he bangs one through after a crazy night. 29-28.
You have knowledge, but knowledge has to be translated on the field. And Brady was the only one that could translate that on the field, bro.
Brady looking that way and fires that way. And it's going to be caught in his Godwin making the catch. And to the 18-yard line he goes.
He's going to be remembered for a long time, whether he makes this one or misses it.
Got it. They finally have a kicker in Tampa Bay.
Brady's been in every situation football could possibly throw at him, but I don't think anything could prepare him for this. You can't practice this.
The emotional weight of this game will distract
creature of habit, Tom Brady.
Look at the pieces of the New England Patriots every year.
Right.
Tom was there 20 years, right?
Yep.
The pieces to that motherfucking puzzle changed consistently year in, year out.
Right.
What one piece never changed, but they kept winning?
A magical night in Foxborough. Most anticipated regular season game in recent memory.
Brady's going to want to come out here and put on a show, right? This is sort of his night, and so what's Belichick going to want him to do? And all the things that Brady's not going to want to be.
He has never stepped into Foxborough in this bizarre setting.
To set the record. Fires caught, and that should do it.
It is going to be ugly for your Patriots. I'm sorry, but that's the truth.
29-yard field goal attempt by Ryan Succop.
I know you're not happy about Mac Jones.
No, I'm not.
You call it an uninspired pick.
I'm not excited.
And I don't understand it, quite frankly.
So Mac Jones is the rookie quarterback. Picked in the first round. He was the fifth quarterback chosen. Jones fires. That's caught and getting into the end zone. Hunter Henry for the touchdown.
The Bucs could deactivate Brady and start Kyle Trask. They're still going to win. The Patriots stink.
That's a big boy drive.
Here we go. Let's go. Let's go. Catch your breath. Let's go. You ready to go? Do it again.
Brady, look out. And there is Judon again.
I don't know if you're saying three down or four down. You and I have to talk.
Gotcha.
Turn and tell me three down or four down.
Oh, look out, the ball is out, and it's picked up by the Bucs. Richard Sherman comes.
You can't speak hypotheticals when there's a fact on what he just did. He left New England, went to Tampa Bay, and did what his first year.
Jones again to the outside. Jones to the end zone. Touchdown. Ali Marpet leading the way, and then he goes for the score as Tampa takes the lead. Good game, breaking tackles. Harris all the way out to the 45.
When you have a rookie quarterback that watches Tom Brady take his team down, score, take the lead, you start going, oh, okay, the inevitable is going to happen. And every time it's happened tonight, Mac Jones has come right back the other way.
Harris is the back. Pick his hand.
All right, we've talked about what this would mean to Tom Brady and Bill Belichick. What would a win tonight mean to Mac Jones?
So glad we almost made. So sad.
Rushing four. Brady stepping up. Brady will take off, and Brady's going to pick up a first down.
Mac Jones is, in fact, the legacy ender for Bill Belichick.
To the ground. Oh, razzle dazzle. Myers, the old high school quarterback, throws. It's Aguilar to the 10-yard line to give them the lead, which he does. Pick up a 10th third down conversion tonight. Brady with time. Brady to the end zone, and that is not caught. Lane bounce. Jones covering on the play. Antonio Brown was there. So second down and six now. Back at their 49-yard line. They want another false start. They don't get it. To the outside. Bolden, and Bolden will pick up the first down and get out of bounds. Pass to the outside. Is it caught inbounds? Yes, it is. Myers is there.
But it is impressive to see how Mac Jones has been able to find his rhythm offensively, and that's due to Bill Belichick.
But in all likelihood, probably going for here on fourth down, right? Would you try this kind of a long field goal?
Not 56 yards in the rain. I think they go for it on a fourth down if they have to. Meanwhile, that's a catch, and now you're going to have to make that decision. The line of scrimmage is the 37.
Career long is 56. I remind you, though, he has had that issue on his plant leg. This would match his longest ever, and if he hits this one in the rain with a bad plant leg, it would be one amazing night.
From 56. On its way. It is off the goalpost. No good. You can hear the doink. Oh, man.
Unbelievable.
Mr. Jones tonight, he impressed a lot of people around the National Football League, and of course Belichick knew exactly what he was doing. Cam Newton was going to be the starter. Bill said that he was going to be the starter up until about June, and now it's this man.
Great job, keep it up. JC,
good plan, big boy. You know how to go after too much today.
I know,
man. I look it awesome. Yes, love you too.
Evans, 600 it is.
Oh, that was the 600.
Gotcha. I've never heard of 600 in anything in football, but Brady has it with a strike to Evans over the middle using his size. And how good is that 600, Jim?
Third down and four. Gronk's in there. Brady gonna run for it. Right down the middle of the field, and he slides down. Tom showing off the wheels tonight. Picks up an 11.
Waiting on third down to the end zone, Gronkowski. His second touchdown today.
Third passer against the Bills defense all year. And here he is on third and three from the pocket. Connecting.
That's Perriman taking it all the way for the win. The first time he had been targeted the entire game, Rashad Perriman. What a play to...
The Bucs once again soared to a playoff berth, but the cracks of dysfunction that would ultimately manifest the following year began to show.
Very odd situation. Antonio Brown boiled over, very upset on the sideline, took off his shoulder pads. Mike Evans, O.J. Howard trying to convince him to keep them on, and ran across the field while the teams were still on the field, giving the crowd a peace out sign.
I've never seen anything like that. I've been affiliated with the NFL for over 30 years, and I have never seen anything like that in those 30 years. It's just baffling to me.
I thought it was like some crazy fan. Crazy. Fires open. That midfield to the 45, and inside the 45 is Tyler Johnson. 49 seconds counting, less than that. Made sure he didn't get out of bounds. 25 seconds. Catch made to the end zone. Cyril Grayson.
We can make any debate we want about Aaron Rodgers and how great he is and how talented he is, but I'm taking the guy that in the biggest moment always plays his best football.
It's not even close. I mean, I get it. I like Aaron Rodgers. He's got phenomenal talent. He's got arm strength, his mind, his body. Oh, I get it.
So the defense now waking up the Bucs.
Third and 20. Stafford going for it all. He's got a wide open man. It's Cooper Kupp who gets free. And Kupp rolls all the way to the end zone on a third and 20.
But I'm taking a dude that's 44 damn years old. It's not even close, Stephen, eh?
Running this time wide to the left.
You take the guy that finds a way in the biggest moment to make that play.
Brady going deep down the right side. High for Evans. He makes the catch. He's in for the score.
are we surprised?
I don't know. You have to play offense.
You do?
You have to play offense here. I know it's scary. I know it's Tom Brady on the other side. You have to play offense here.
Give it to Brady with maybe a minute and 20. Second down and 7. Akers. Oh, he lost the ball! And the Buccaneers come up with it at the 30-yard line. And Ndamukong Suh.
He's playing to win championships. He's playing to write more of a legacy, to win back-to-back championships, to do things that people have never done before.
Third down and 10 with 1:10. Evans to the left, Miller to the right. Brady in the slot. Brady looks over the middle. That's caught. Brady makes the grab. Under a minute. Put the ball down.
Ruling on the field stands as called. The runner is short of the line of the game. It's fourth down.
Brady's amazing. Never seen anything like him. The clutchest quarterback I've ever seen.
Here we go.
Look at the pile of players in there to try and stop this.
Can they keep it alive? Brady's going to hand it off. It's Fournette. He's going to take it to the end zone. This is officially lunacy. You think Brady gave that talk at halftime? Hey, boys, it was down 28-3. This is nothing.
Remember we were talking about the Bucs were never able to put the Rams under pressure? They're under pressure now.
Major. Stafford. Deep downfield. He's got cut. He's got to get out of bounds, and he is able to do that. Oh, I want some more. Oh, what are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? Stafford, deep downfield. He's got Cup again. He's at the 10. Stafford says, let's get down there. We got to clock it. We got to get the field goal. Are you ready for Matt Gay to come in? He spikes it there, and Matt Gay will come in and try to win the game. 30 yards to win the game. Matt Gay boots it through. And the Rams, by the hair of their skinny teeth, team,
wind up winning it. Three games so far. A walk-off field goal.
Yes.
All three.
Yes.
I'd say it reminds me so much of Tom Brady's first Super Bowl. You know, he got the ball back. All the momentum had shifted the other way.
Biggest name in football, Tom Brady, made the most headlines this year. Let's see. He retired. He unretired. He's got a new gig in TV when he eventually does retire. He's got a new head coach. He left camp for 11 days. A lot of questions around him. With all that, what are you expecting on the field tonight?
Brady. Evans. Did he catch it? Yes, sir. Touchdown. Hard to beat in the air. Mike Evans.
I think we got to be careful with that one. One thing we know about Tom Brady is that he's always got a reason
Brady
to win.
Going end zone. It is caught for the touchdown. Russell Gage hauls it in.
And they got to get, what's your best third? What's your best goal to go play from the 7?
Pressure. Steps away. Throwing tip. Incomplete. The Packers are going to win it.
At the end of that first half last week against Atlanta. Atlanta in a position to get 3. They miss it, and Tampa goes down and steals 3.
And now look at this. The ball comes free out of Brady's right arm, but Godwin is able to jump on it and get Tampa the ball back. Alex Highsmith came with the pressure.
It's got 3 new faces back there. It's the top 3 quarterbacks for the Steelers are out this afternoon.
That's what Mike Tomlin said. He said, pressure doesn't set Tom Brady. You have to get there with four, and now he is fired up talking to his offense on the sideline. As Tampa is going to fall to 3-3.
You're talking about an offense that struggled to run the football all season long. They've struggled to overcome third and longs.
Plus yards on defense.
From the 36-yard line, Brady fires downfield, and the pass is bobbled and dropped by Mike Evans. Would have had an easy touchdown.
Oh my goodness, you never see him do that.
Walker fires, caught, touchdown, Tommy Tremble.
And Brady, and what do we have here? We have a flag.
Fournette left early.
He did.
This red zone is kind of the Tampa Bay Bucks in a nutshell all these last few weeks.
Number seven, offense, 5-yard penalty.
Just self-destructing penalties.
Pressure comes. Up high, it's intercepted. Deshaun Gibson has got it for San Francisco, and he's got room to run into Tampa territory. Inside the 40 and out of bounds there. And this number one defense is rolling.
A lot of movement there. Brady gets the snap. Flag is down. Julio's got it. Jumped to the end zone for the touchdown. But we saw the movement. And I think two players were in motion at the same time. And this one will come back.
Legal shift. Offense. Number 9 and number 88. Both men were in motion.
This offense has scored in the last 6 weeks no more than 22 points. No more than in 6 weeks. This is who they are. It's the worst run game in the NFL. The ball has to come out of the quarterback's hands so quickly because they can't protect.
And these opportunities, 43 career comebacks in the fourth quarter or overtime, tied for the most with Peyton Manning since 1970. Will be passed to Godwin, is caught up near midfield, first down. Wide open, Otten coming off the touchdown catch. Quick throw, pass caught, first down, Scotty Miller.
You know, we're all fortunate to see this. This is the greatest of all time.
Here's one for Jones, what a grab.
But I don't think we'll ever see another Tom Brady.
Just a beautiful catch by the seven-time Pro Bowl 33-year-old Julio Jones. Brady, end zone, Godwin, touchdown, Tampa Bay. But a flag back at the 13-yard line. Let's see if it counts.
Holding, offense number 76, 3-yard penalty, and play first down.
They get Donovan Smith again. Now time is an issue with 12 seconds left.
Tom Brady made himself great. He wasn't great. He wasn't great in college. He lost his job, which is what fueled him his whole life. He's the most competitive person anybody's ever met.
Sideline, Godwin cannot stay in bounds.
And he worked harder than anybody ever to be this good. He made himself
it's third down.
This good.
Underneath, and touchdown, Rashad White. Point to come. Forty-fourth career comeback in the fourth quarter or overtime. The most all time now. Breaking that tie with Peyton Manning. A go-ahead pass in his incredible 23-year career.
Tom Brady is basically saying, I choose not to compete anymore. To say that, you know, I'm done, I'm retiring, is hard for that, for Tom to say.
This game is over, and the Buccaneers are 6-6, and on top in the NFC South.
I think the finality of it, I think last season weighed a lot. Skippy has started to look gone. And I don't know if what happened off the field, had that been brewing, weighed on his mind. It had to have weighed on his mind.
Second and 10. Prescott projected. End zone. Caught. Touchdown. Dalton Schultz. Second down and 4. Prescott. End zone. Touchdown. Dallas. Schultz's second of the night.
The Bucs put up a fight, but they were outmatched by Dallas.
Against the look, got what they hoped for. Good protection. End of the quarter. Catch is made. Touchdown, Julio Jones.
And just listening at his voice and as it starts to break, you see the hurt, the pain that, you know what, it's over.
Good protection and the pass wide open. Touchdown, Lamb. A total breakdown in coverage.
And if you watched him, you watched him this season, I think most people realize that, yeah, Tom, it's time to hang.
Shake hands and find Dak Prescott, if in fact this is it. For Tom Brady, all I can say on behalf of all football fans is thank you and appreciate the memories. What a career.
If it's not, come back to Tampa Bay. There was a report that at least three teams will come calling for his services next year. He's got a deal in place with Fox to go to the broadcast booth. If he chooses to do that, who knows? And as he told us, I'm going to take a lot of time. There's going to be no limit on how long I take. I'll know when I know. Decompress after a long year off the field, his personal life, and on the field with a team that got to the playoffs but came up way short tonight.
Morning, guys. I'll get to the point right away. I'm retiring for good. Really thank you guys so much to every single one of you for supporting me, my family, my friends, my teammates, my competitors. I could go on forever. There's too many. Thank you guys for allowing me to live my absolute dream. I wouldn't change a thing. Love you all.
Diego, now they back off. Great. Look at the time he has. Brady.
It's the greatest one ever. So, congratulations, Tom.
Appreciate it.
Tom, what did Bill do to bring out the best in you?
I think it's more what did he not do to bring out the best in you.
So this is a lot of stuff that Belichick talks about in team meetings that I write down. These are kind of his themes, so I'll read you some of them. Prepare and play well. Super Bowl environment is all about hype and ridiculous bull that will go on. People would say, hey man, this is what it is. I reached my goal, my dream, my life is me. I thank God. It's got to be more than this.
Leaves the Patriots with 3rd and 10. Brady with time. Going back again to Moss. Touchdown, Patriots.
What's the answer? Wish I knew. I've done it. 27. And what else is there for me?
Oh man, this is painful. Just clicking on it, just
What are we watching?
2007 Super Bowl. This one's still.
I never thought another trophy could feel as special, but this one absolutely does. And tonight, once again, the Patriots are world champions.
I want to thank my family and all my friends who have supported me, all my teammates. I love you guys. This is for you guys.
He's in! Patriots win the Super Bowl! Brady has his fifth! What a comeback!
Enjoy it, folks. You're never, ever going to see it again. Not in our lifetime.
Nope. I mean, he has done more for the NFL than any other player in history. He has three Hall of Fame careers on his resume, one in his 20s, one in his 30s, and one in his 40s.
Crazy.
And he has set that bar that all these modern-day era QBs will be chasing, and that's seven Super Bowls.
I think we knew this was going to happen, didn't we?